Welcome to my channel Pyare's Programming. Today's topic is if condition, where we will write a program to arrange three numbers without using loop. We know that if else is a replacement for switch case and switch case is a replacement for if else. Is it possible that we can replace while loop with if condition? Can if condition will be a replacement for loop? We know we can arrange the numbers either using bubble sort or selection sort. For that, we need loop. Is it possible that without using loop, we can arrange the data or we can sort the data? Let's see how we can do it. Let's check it with an example. Suppose user has entered three numbers. First number is 91, second number is 72, and third number is 41. These are the description for the variables. First of all, I will check if the first number is greater than the second number and first number is greater than the third number. If first number is bigger than both the numbers, then which one is the biggest one? First one is the biggest one. So I got the first one. What about the middle and the last number? That will be obviously between your second and third number, because we have already got this first number as the biggest one. So I will check the second with third. Though I want it in descending order, I will check with a greater than symbol. If the second one is greater than the third one, obviously which one is the second biggest? The second number will be your second biggest, which is my middle number. If this is the middle number, which one is the last one? Obviously, third is my last one. So I will assign the third variable value to the last one. Now, suppose this is false. That means this is not my second biggest. Which one is second biggest? The third one will be my second biggest. So that's why the middle number is equals to third one. If this is my second biggest, which one is the last number? Second is my last number. That's why I will assign second to the last one. Now let's take some value to check this. As per the user inputted value, first one is 91 and second one is 72. 91 is greater than 72, true. I'm using AND operator over here. So that's why I will check the second condition also. 91 is greater than 41 because third one is 41. Both the condition is true. So that's why result is true. If the result is true, biggest is equal to first one and I will assign the first number to the biggest one. After that, I will find out the second biggest. So that's why I will check the second number 72 greater than 41. This is also true. That means the second biggest or my middle number is second one. I will assign the second number to the middle one. If I got the second number or the middle value, obviously the last one is my third number. So that's why I will assign third number to the last one, which is 41. Now let's check with one more example. Now this time user has inputted first number 91, second number 32, and the third number is 41. So, first number is 91 is greater than the second number 32. True. First number is greater than the third number. Both the condition is true. Obviously, the first one is the biggest one. So, that's why biggest number is equals to 91, which is first one. Now, I have to check with second and third for the second biggest. If the second one is greater than third one, second one is 32 and third one is 41. So, this is false. So I will execute the else part. Now in else part, if this is not the second biggest, which one is the second biggest? This one. So obviously this one will be my middle number. So that's why I'm assigning third to the middle one. That's why middle number is your 41. You can check the color. Green color is available for this one. And third number is the second biggest. So that's why your second number is equals to last. Now let's check one more case. If the first number is not greater than the second one, or the first number is not greater than the third one, what will happen? That means if the initial if condition is false, then I will use else if. Why else if? Suppose if second number is not the biggest one, else is required for the third one. So that's why here I'm checking. Just like here I was targeting the first number to check whether it is first biggest number or not. Like this, in the else if part, I will target the second number as the first biggest number or not. Because this is false. If this is false, first number is not the first biggest one. If the second number is greater than the first one and second number is greater than the third one, obviously my second number is the first biggest. So that's why I will assign the second number to the biggest one. After that, I have to find out the middle number. Middle number obviously will be available out of these two, because second number is taken into consideration as the first biggest number. So that's why middle number will be out of these two, first number and third. So I'm checking if the first number is greater than the third number. So that means this is my second biggest, because out of first and third, this one is the greater than. So that's why I will assign first to the middle number. If it is not, then obviously the third one will be my last number. Now suppose this is false. In that case, this first number is not greater than the third number. That means which one is the biggest number? This one is the biggest number. So obviously my middle number will be the third one in this case. And what is the last one? This is left. So that's why last is equals to first number. Now let's take some value to check this. User has inputted over here. First number is 51. Second number is 95. And third number is 12. 51 is greater than 92. It is false. Now if it is false, it will come to else if part. In this, second number is 95, which is greater than 51. True. Again, I will check. Second number is 95 greater than 12, which is my third number. Both the condition is true. Result is true. So that's why I will assign the second number to the biggest one. So that's why the biggest value is your 95. I will find out the middle number. In that case, I will check again. First is greater than third, because second already taken into consideration as the biggest one. So out of first and third, we'll find out the second biggest. So first one is 51 and the third one is 12. 51 greater than 12, it is true. So that means obviously this is my second biggest or the middle number. So that's why I will assign first number to the middle one. And here we got the middle one as 51. If middle is 51, obviously the third value inputted by the user will be the last value. So that's why last is equals to 12. Now let's check one more case. Here, user has inputted the first number 12, second number 95 and third number 51. So let's check it out. 12 is greater than 92, which is false. That means I will check the else part. In else part, second number is 95, first number is 12, true. Second number is 95, third number is 51, which is also true. Both the condition is true, result is true. That means I will assign the second one as the first biggest number. So that's why my biggest number is 95. After that, I will find out the middle number, which is the second biggest one out of these two, first and third. So that's why first is greater than third. What is first value? 12. What is third value? 51. 12 greater than 51, which is false. That means I will move to the else part. In the else part, which one is the biggest? Because it is false. That means my second biggest is the third value entered by the user. That's why my middle number is equals to third. And what is my last number? My last number will be the first one. Now let's take one more case. Here we are considering if the first condition is false, that means the first number is not the biggest one. Then I will come to the else if part, where we are targeting to check the first biggest number is the second one or not. If this is also false, that means second number is also not the first biggest number. If first is not the first biggest number and the second number inputted by the user is also not the first biggest number, which one is the first biggest number? Third one. So that's why in else part, I am saying biggest number is equal to third one. If we got the third one as the first biggest number, so middle, or we can say second biggest number, will be between your first number and second number. So that's why I'm checking first number is greater than second number. If it is true, that means this will be my second biggest number or the middle number. So that's why first number is assigned to middle number. And what is the last? We got third one or the first biggest, second one or the middle one. Obviously, the last one will be my second one. So that's why last is equals to second. If this is false, then I will come to the else part, where we are saying if it is false, then first is not the second biggest number. So obviously, which one? Second will be my first biggest number. So that's why second is assigned to middle one. And obviously, the last one is left for the first one. So that's why last is equals to first. Let's take some value to check this. First number is 45 because user has inputted 45 was the first number. Second number is 12. 45 greater than 12. It is true. I will check again. 45 is greater than 91 because third number is inputted by the user is 31, which is false. I'm using AND operator. If either one condition is false, result is false. That's why the if condition is false. I will come back to this else if part, where I'm checking the second number 12 is greater than the first number 45, false. As we know, either one condition is false, result is false. That's why else if also false. I will come to the else part, where third number is the biggest one, because first number is not the biggest one. Second number is not the biggest one. Obviously, third number will be my biggest one. So that's why biggest will become your 91. After getting third number as the first biggest, we'll find out the second biggest or the middle number out of this second and first. So I will check. First is 45. Second is 12. It is true. That means middle is equals to first one. So middle value will be 45. Obviously, the last one is my second number. So last is 12. Now let's check the last case. This time user has inputted the first number as 18, second number as 52. So that's why 18 greater than 52 is false. If it is false, I will come to else if part, where second number is 52, first number is 18, which is true. Second number is 52, third number is 91. This part is false. We know that if either one condition is false, result is false. So that's why here I will come to the else part. We found the biggest number is the third one. So third one is my biggest number. We got 91. Then we'll check if first is greater than the second one. If it is true, I know we'll do this part. But this time it is false. Let's see. First is 18. Second is 52, which is false. So I will come to else part. Middle is equal to second. And if we got the second one as the middle number and the third one as the first biggest, obviously the last one will be my first number. So we got last is equals to 18. Now it's time to check the program. My My first job is to import. So that's why import java.util.star for scanner class. After that, class, then class name. Class name is your choice. Opening curly bracket and closing curly bracket indicates body of the class. Then public, static, void, main, string, square bracket, any object. I have taken PMS because the program execution starts from main. So that's why I'm having main method, and this is the body of the main method. So first job is to create a scanner class object. New scanner, within parenthesis I will say system.in, because with the help of scanner class object we are going to accept the data. I will give message system.out.print, and here the message will be in double quotes, enter the first number, int f is equals to ss is the scanner class object, dot next int is the method name to accept a number. Similarly, I will give one more message, enter the second number, and I will change the variable to s. Similarly, I will say enter third number, I will change the variable to t. Here I will take three more variables, that is beginning, middle and last, or end, whatever may be your choice variable. My first condition is I will target the first number. So that's why I'll say first is greater than second, as well as first is greater than third. If the first is bigger than second and third, so I will say beginning is equals to first. After that, I have to find it out the middle and the last from the second and third. So that's why I will check if second is greater than third. So I will say what is the middle number? Middle number is going to be the second one, because first one is already considered as the biggest number, and out of these two, second one is the biggest. So middle position will contain your second value. After that, I will say the last is equals to which one? Third one, because first is over, second is over, obviously the last one is third one. Now if it is false, out of these two, which one is biggest? Third one is biggest, so obviously my middle will be third one. If first is over and third is over, which one is left? Second. So I will say last is equals to second. Now if this part is false, then first is not the biggest one, so I will target for the second number. So I will say else if second is greater than first, as well as second is greater than third. So which one is the biggest? So beginning is equals to second. If we got the second one is the biggest number, that means second biggest will be available between first and third. So I will say if, because two variables are there, I have to check it again. If first is greater than third, then out of these two, which one is biggest? First one. Already the beginning position is found, the middle will be your first one. So that's why I will say middle is equals to first. If not, then we have already used second one as the biggest, first one is also considered. So which one is left? Third one. So last is equals to third one. If it is false, then out of these two, which one is biggest? Third one. So obviously my middle is equals to third, and the last is equals to which one is over? Second is covered, third is covered. So which one is left? First one. So obviously the first one is the last one. And if this is false, above one, first is not the biggest one, second one, second is not the biggest one. So obviously else part is for third one. So beginning is equals to third. If beginning is equals to third, which two variables are left? First and second. So I will say if first is greater than second, then out of these two, which one is the biggest? First one. So that's why middle is equals to first, and the last is equals to third is considered. Here first is considered, which one is left? Second. So last is equals to second. If this one is false, which one? This one is false, then which one is the biggest one? Second one. So t is considered as the first biggest, so obviously s will be the middle or the second biggest. So I will say middle is equals to second. Then what will be the last? Third is already considered. Here I have considered second. Which one is left? First. So last is equals to first. After coming out of these all conditions, I will display system.out.print. I will display the first biggest, which is available at the beginning, plus I'm arranging it. So that's why beginning concatenated with comma, then middle concatenated with comma, and the last one. So let's execute. I'm giving 45, 11, 99. We got 99, 45, 11 arranged. Let's check one more example. Here I'm giving 11, 99, 47. We got 99, 47, 11 arranged in a descending order. Now let's make the first one is the biggest one. I'm saying 99, 3, and the last one I'm saying 80. We got 99, 80, and 3. I think everyone has understood it clearly. Now, thank you for watching my video. If you need any other video where you are facing problem to write the program, you are most welcome. But you have to do a small thing. You have to write which program you are unable to understand or which program you are unable to do in my YouTube comment section. Then I will create the video and I will try to minimize the logic and the code, and I will try my level best to make you understand from the video. Thank you.